Dr. Flossie Wong Stahl is a Chinese-American virologist and molecular biologist. She was the first scientist to clone HIV and determine the function of its genes to prove that HIV is a cause of AIDS. Flossie Wong Stahl was born in 1947 with the name Yi Ching Wong. She grew up in communist China, but in 1952, she fled to Hong Kong with her family following the communist revolution. She attended an all-girls Catholic school in Hong Kong, where she excelled and eventually took up an interest in science. While in the Hong Kong school system, she had to decide whether she wanted to go into a science or non-science field. Her teachers and family encouraged her to study science, despite the fact that no woman in her family had ever worked outside the home or studied in the field of science. Throughout her childhood, Flossie was interested in literature and poetry, and not very interested in science, but she quickly came to love it. She eventually came to the United States with a new name, Flossie Wong Stahl. Her high school had encouraged her to adopt an English name, and her father chose her new name after the typhoon Flossie that had previously struck Hong Kong. She received a bachelor's degree in bacteriology from the University of California, Los Angeles, and later received a doctorate in molecular biology. Flossie's main contributions were in virology and molecular biology. She started her research studying primate retroviruses and looked at them to determine if they could be used as models for eventual application to the human system. Her main area of study, however, dealt with HIV and AIDS. After the human retrovirus was discovered, Flossie was the first to clone HIV and determine the function of its genes. She concluded that HIV depleted T cells, which eventually led to the discussion that HIV is the cause of AIDS. One of the things I admired most about Flossie is her perspective on women in science. She believes that women can achieve as much as men in science or any field, as long as they just do their best and stay true to who they are. I identify with Flossie due to the fact that virology is an area of biology that interests me. New viruses are constantly being discovered, and I think that determining what causes these viruses and how we can prevent them is a very intriguing field of study that Flossie devoted a large majority of her time to and something I would like to get into in the future. The most recent paper Flossie is an author on is using oncolytic viral therapy as a personalized cancer vaccine. Clinical and animal studies conducted support the idea that viral therapy functions as an anti-tumor immunotherapy. The viruses tested include the adenovirus, herpes simplex virus or HSV, vaccinia virus VV, and Newcastle disease virus NDV. Two phases of trials were conducted on the different viruses to determine the tumor responses and anti-tumor immunity. Through the phases, it was determined that the overall patient survival rate increased and demonstrated anti-tumor immunity with the use of oncolytic viruses. The enhanced anti-tumor immunity of these viral therapies are evident from the increase in specific immune cells. Genetic modifications of viral vectors can continue to enhance the capacities of oncolytic viruses to activate anti-tumor immunity by removing viral immunosuppressive components and introducing pro-immune transgenes. During her career, Flossie uncovered a wide variety of things. With the aid of her team, she discovered HIV and became the first person to clone it and genetically map the virus, which led to the identification that HIV depletes T cells, causing AIDS. She has now retired but started her own pharmaceutical company, originally Immuzol, but later rebranded to iTherX, where she and her team are focusing on hepatitis C therapies. In her free time, Flossie loves to dance and spend time with her four grandchildren, as she enjoys watching their joy as they learn new things. She hopes that science will continue to be a huge part of her life and the lives of her grandchildren.